Hallelujah.
Well, good morning.
Hallelujah. Good morning.
Come on, let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Anybody glad to be together with your brothers and sisters in the Lord? Hallelujah. Come on, why don't you go ahead and stand to your feet? Why don't you go ahead and give God your best praise this morning? Hallelujah, because he's been that good. He's been so good to us. Amen. Amen. We can never, ever get enough of his love. Amen. Oh, I don't care how many people have loved you before. There's nobody that can love you like Jesus. Hallelujah. He gives us that joy, that love, that peace, and that mercy. And that's what we come to celebrate. Anybody ready to celebrate Jesus? Oh, that don't sound like it. Anybody ready to celebrate the Lord this morning? Come on, put those hands together. Come on. I don't see you clapping yet. Now, everybody ought to know this song. Here we go. Oh, you give me that joy.
You give me that joy like a river.
Come on, that mercy.
You give me that mercy I never deserve.
Tell them about that love.
You give me that love, nothing better.
That sweet peace.
You give me that sweet peace like never before.
There's nobody like.
There's nobody like God, like God.
Tell them who you're talking about.
I'm talking about my God, my God.
Hey, there's nobody like.
There's nobody like God, like God.
Yeah.
I'm talking about my God, my God.
Oh, you give me that joy.
You give me that joy like the river.
That love,
give me that love, nothing better. Give me that sweet peace like never before.
Oh, there's nobody like.
There's nobody like God, like God.
I'm talking about my
I'm
God.
I'm talking about my God, my God.
Oh, there's nobody.
There's nobody like God, like God.
Who you talking about? Who you talking about?
I'm talking about my God, my God.
Oh, you give me that joy.
You give me that joy like a river.
Anybody experiences joy? Come on.
You give me that mercy I never deserve.
Said that his mercies are new every morning.
You give me that love, nothing better.
I'm talking about my
I'm
God.
I'm talking about my God, my God.
Come on, now just let him know. Oh, your love is so amazing.
Your love is so amazing.
Your love is so incredible.
Your love is so incredible.
Your love is so amazing.
Your love is so amazing.
Your love is so incredible.
Your love is so incredible.
Your love is so amazing.
Your love is so amazing.
Your love is so incredible.
Your love is so incredible.
Your love is so amazing.
Your love is so amazing.
Your love is so incredible.
Your love is so incredible.
And I'll never get enough of your love, Jesus.
Never get enough of your love.
I'll never get enough of your love, Lord.
Never get enough of your love.
Your love, Jesus.
Never get enough of your love.
I'll never get enough, never get enough, never.
Never get enough, never get enough, never.
I'll never get enough of your love, Jesus.
Never get enough of your love.
I'll never, never get enough of your love, Lord.
Never get enough of your love.
You'll never get enough of your love, Jesus.
Never get enough of your love.
I'll never get enough, never get enough, never. celebrate his love this morning. Hallelujah. He's so good. Hallelujah. Good. Hallelujah. He's good to you and me. Amen.
Good morning, Antioch. Good morning to everyone that's here in the sanctuary this morning. Those that are watching us online this morning, hallelujah, the declaration has gone out that he's good, that he's so good, that there's no one like him. Hallelujah, no one can do the things that he does. He's good. Hallelujah, I heard Brother Eric say he's good. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Father, in the precious name of Jesus, we thank you for your goodness this morning. We thank you for all that you have done for us, all that you continue to do for us, dear God. Truly, you have shown yourself good and so strong towards us, dear God. We ask, Heavenly Father, as we come together individually and collectively this morning, that you would bless us, dear God, that you would shower down your blessings from on high, dear God, for every good and every perfect gift comes from above. Lord, we're just waiting on you this morning. We're here anticipating this morning with expectation. Hallelujah. We know that you're going to give us just what we need this morning. So God, we ask that you bless our pastor. Continue to be with him, dear God. Give him a word, dear God, on this series that's so precious to us, dear God. So we thank you. We glorify you. We give you honor in the name of Jesus. Now receive your blessing. Hallelujah. Receive it. Open up your hearts right now. Receive the blessing. Hallelujah, that God has for you. For he's going to send his word this morning to heal you. No matter what it is you're going through, you're going to get it this morning. I speak it and I declare it, dear God. Hallelujah. His word is true. And God, we thank you for it. In Jesus' name, we do pray. Amen. Amen.
Amen. If you come to receive from the Lord, don't you keep quiet right now. Hallelujah. Won't you make a joyful noise to him? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're your people. Oh God, we come to give you praise. Anybody know he stands forever? Whatever promise he keeps, no matter how long it takes, he's going to perform it. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
So we won't keep quiet, and we won't be ashamed. We'll keep confessing, Jesus, you reign. No matter how long, we'll keep on praying, but nothing can stop you. You will remain always. You stand forever. You stand forever. You stand forever. You stand forever. We won't
keep quiet.
We'll keep confessing.
Jesus reigns.
Come on.
No matter how long.
Keep on.
We'll keep on praying.
Nothing can stop you.
Nothing can stop you. We'll keep confessing.
What you gonna say? Jesus, you reign.
Jesus, you reign.
worship you, Lord.
You stand forever. You stand forever.
You stand.
Stand forever.
You know what? We won't stop. I want you to make that declaration. Calling your name. Calling your name. We won't quit. Seeking your face, seeking your face, we won't stop.
Anybody not gonna stop?
Yeah. Calling your name, we won't quit. Yeah. Seeking your face,
we won't stop.
Yeah. Come on, lift your voice.
Calling on your name, oh God.
Calling your name, yeah. Calling your name, we won't quit.
Anybody gonna seek his face?
Yeah. Seeking your face. Yeah. Seeking your face, we won't stop.
Anybody love calling on the name of Jesus?
Calling your name. Calling your name, we won't quit.
Say, seeking your face, oh God.
Seeking your face. Yeah. Seeking your face, we won't stop. Uh-huh.
Say, calling your name, oh God.
Calling your name. Calling your name, we won't quit.
Seeking your face, oh God.
Seeking your face. Seeking your face, we won't stop.
Calling your name, oh God.
Calling your name. Calling your name, we won't quit.
No other name we know. Seeking your face, oh God.
Seeking your face.
We want you.
We want you.
We want you, Lord.
We want you.
More of you.
We want you.
No one else will do, Lord. We want you.
We want
That's
you.
That's why we bow.
We
That's
want
That's why
you.
We cry.
We want you.
Say, we want you.
We want you.
Pour our heart.
We want you.
Our heart.
We want you.
We give you everything we have today.
We want you.
We want you.
We want you.
We want you, Lord. We want you.
We want you.
Open our hearts.
We want you.
A word from the Lord.
We want you.
We want you. We want you.
We want you.
We want you, Lord.
We want you.
We want you.
We want you.
When you
say, stand forever.
Anybody needs to know.
As a congregation, we just sing this part.
Hey, we won't stop.
Yeah,
so call your name. Calling your name. Calling your name. We won't quit. Seeking your face, oh God.
Seeking your face.
Seeking your face. We won't stop. Calling your name, oh God. Give me your face, Lord.
Seeking your face.
Seeking your face, we won't stop.
Amen. Thank you, Lord God.
Pastor Jones, Pastor Thomas, Antioch family and friends, and those visiting us online, good morning.
Good morning.
Please stand for the responsive reading. Today's responsive reading will come from Hebrews chapter 11, verses 1 through 4 and 6. I'll read the part of the leader, and you'll read the part of the congregation. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Through faith we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. Altogether, but without faith it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Today's hymn will be hymn 394, Stand Up for Jesus. Jones, First Lady Jones, ministers, Antioch family and friends, and those watching us online, good morning. How are y'all feeling today? Oh, that's so good. Antioch, get ready to close out 2023 with our annual Watch Night service at 10 p.m. on December 31st, 2023. We will still hold our regular church service at 10 a.m. However, there will be no Sunday school at 9 a.m. Come join one of our small group Sunday school classes at 9 a.m. Adult classes are held in the sanctuary and on Zoom. Head to our website for the link. Children's Sunday school classes will be held in the classrooms only. There will be no Bible study this Wednesday. There will be no Bible study this Wednesday. I hope all of you have a great Thanksgiving and enjoy time with your friends and family. PSA to all my kids. Now, when they introduce you to that auntie and uncle you have not seen since you were 5 months old, just smile and act like you know. As always, we ask that you keep our sick, shut-in, and bereaved families in your thoughts and prayers. Is there anyone that celebrated a birthday since last Sunday? Happy birthday. How about any anniversaries? Oh. Happy anniversary. Don't forget to like us on Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube channel at ambcoviedo. Now, since you're probably on your phone right now, you should go and download the Antioch app and join the community. It's available in the Google Play Store for them Androids and the Apple Store for the regular phones. You can also download the app on Amazon Kindle, Apple TVs, and Roku. To find the app, type in Antioch ambcoviedo. Please create a profile and allow notifications to stay up to date with things going on in Antioch. If you have to delete the app because you don't have enough space, delete it. Candy Crush will be all right. Do we have any visitors today? If so, please stand so the ushers could give you a visitor's card. No? Oh, oh. Welcome. Hope you're having a fun time. Have a great day and a blessed week. And now some video announcements.
So, how about you guys follow me to come and see what's going on Wednesday night in youth and young adult world?
Hey, what's good, y'all? Y'all need to come through. Hang out.
Now let's see who's going to win. Charlie Brown?
Soccer player.
IBC? Or Team Messi? Exactly.
They talking about Jesus being somebody who's going to be marred beyond human likeness.
And guess what I did? Did I go outside?
You had an attitude. I know. You had an attitude. You had an attitude.
I had a quiet attitude. I didn't talk about
you were ugly.
Good morning, Antioch. Good morning. It's offering time. Amen. There are three ways to give: by giving online at antioch-mbc.org, or by dropping off tithes and offerings in the basket by the doors, or you can mail it to 311 East Broadway Street at Oviedo, Florida, 32765. Now let's pray. Dear God, we thank you for this day and allowing everyone to be able to come. We also thank you for provision to be able to give. Lord, bless those that give and those that had a desire to give but are unable to give. Lord, I pray that the offering is used for the uplifting of your kingdom. It is in your son Jesus' name, amen.
Y'all had to help me. I was wondering why Oscar kept looking at me like, "Well, what are you doing?" Amen. We're blessed again to be able to dedicate our baby. And how many that make now? There's three of them now. I think they're gonna get me a baseball team at least. Would y'all come up, Mary and Alan? We were scheduled to have also another baby as well, but unfortunately they won't be able to make it today. But I am so glad y'all come right here. It's baby look at me like, who is this dude, man? What are you finna do? I want to say that it's a blessing to be able to be a part of the dedication of these babies. I think I've had the privilege of dedicating the other two as well. And so I gotta do it quick. I'm getting close to 70 now, so y'all get me all these babies. I want to read the scripture that we always read at the baby dedication. And they always tell us that when you find a church where there is no children, the church is either dead or is dying. Church need children to replenish it. And amen. And we want to say to Ellen, you and your wife Mary, we're so glad that when I was born, I tell you, ain't nobody dedicated me. I just said that was somebody's baby. But to see that you all are taking the time to give God recognition that He entrusted you with these children. And there are people that wish that they could have had the privilege of being the parents of some children biologically, and that never happened. God has graced you all to be able to give you three beautiful children together, and that is something that you ought to never take for granted, but to give God praise for. Can we give God praise for that? And then I love the favorite passage that I like to read when dedicating are these babies, and it comes from Mark chapter 10, verse 13, and it reads, Mark chapter 10, verse 13, it reads, and they brought young children to him. And you know, everybody pretty familiar with the scripture where Jesus was going around doing all kinds of things. He was like healing the sick, raising the dead. He was like exhausted. And some of the disciples was trying to keep people from getting to him because they felt like he was so busy. And in Jewish custom, there would be no way that a rabbi would stop and take time with children, let alone their parents, to bring those children for a rabbi. Caiaphas and Nehemiah, those great men of that time, wouldn't dare take time to pick up little children. But the Bible says this: and they brought young children to him, talking about Jesus, that he should touch them. And his disciples rebuked those that brought them, because traditionally, rabbis didn't have time for that. But Jesus kind of broke the He broke the model. But when Jesus saw it, he was much displeased and said unto them, talking to his disciples, suffer little children to come to me and forbid them not, for such is the kingdom of God. Verily, verily, I say unto you, Jesus always took these moments of teaching moments. Whosoever shall not receive the kingdom of God as a little child, he shall not enter therein. And the Bible says he took them up in his arms and put his hands upon them and he blessed them. I don't know if he's going to let me do this. I'm just going to touch it. Alan, bring him a little closer. He's looking at me right. He's already balling up already. I'm just going to touch him. I'm just going to touch him. All right. He said, I give you that. So, Alan and Mary, it is your duty to receive this child from God's hands, to teach it how to know and to love God, working in obedience to God's will to help in unfolding the child's spiritual life. It is your duty for that. And from your example, not Pastor Jones or Pastor Thomas or anyone else, from your example. And I always say this, that especially little boys, Ellen, I don't care how big these other dudes in the building is, you're the biggest dude in the whole world to him. And from your example, he's going to watch what you do. He's going to watch how you handle your wife. He's going to watch how you do everything. You're going to be his model. And you should be the first model that he know. In fact, how you conduct yourself would give him an idea about what God is like. And today I'm going to be talking a few things about, I don't know if y'all been in the series so far, we're talking about Jabez. That man went through a hard time because he didn't have what you're offering your kids today. From your example, this child must learn how to read and love the Bible. And from your example, this child must learn the way of fellowship with Christ from your example. We have one of the best Sunday school and youth ministries here in this area. We do. And I'm not just saying this because I'm the pastor. It's true. We got some very dedicated teachers and youth leaders in this church that are giving themselves to nurturing and blessing our kids when they're at this facility. Do you, Alan and Mary, promise to pray for this child, that it may grow in the knowledge of God and spiritual life? Do y'all promise to do that? Do you also promise to train this child in body, soul, and mind for the service of fellowship with God? Y'all promise to do that?
Yes.
Alan, I want you to turn to the crowd and let everybody know the child and say it proud, man.
Christian Jordan Pompilus.
I would like at this time for the godparents to come up. Godparents, just stand for a minute. Is it Garrett and Eileen or Aileen?
Eileen.
Did anybody coerce you guys to doing this, force you guys to do this?
No.
No one did it. Y'all volunteered to do it. What you're seeing in the event in front of God in this company, God forbid, that if anything happened to these parents, that you'll be willing to take and raise this baby as if it was your very own. Are you seeing that today? Are you also seeing that you're going to also pray with them, also help in any way possible to help this child grow into the person that God wants him to be? Y'all promise to do that? Can I have now, amen, grandparents become homeboys, homegirls, everybody that came to be with this family? I want to express, I have a fund for grandparents. Well, can I identify the grandparents? Where are the grandparents? Grandparents. Man, I'm in that phase now, man. I say all the time, man, if I could have got my grandkids first before I got my kids, I would have done that. I would have done that first. I'd have got my grandkids first. I have 9 of them now. and look like it don't, the joy from being a grandparent don't ever diminish. I love sugaring them up and sending them back to my kids doing things. And my kids would always rebuke me and says, you know, Mom, Dad, I don't believe that you're letting them get away with that. And so it's good. So in the event, God forbid, that if anything happened to these kids, I know what grandparents say, I ain't raising nobody else's children. I'm done with kids. Raise own kids. But sometimes, and in this room today, there are people who has been raised by their grandparents. Can I get an amen from somebody in the house? And I want to say, God forbid, if anything happened to them, would you all be willing to take this child and raise this child, do it all over again, to raise this child as if it was your own? Would y'all do that?
Yes.
Amen. Pastor Thomas is going to anoint the baby now. He's going to anoint. And what we're doing now, we're saying before God in this company, and what you're saying, Alan Mary, that you guys believe that this baby actually came from God. Because the Bible says children are heritages of the Lord, which means that before you had him first, Alan, God had this baby first. It's millions, trillions, we could even number the kids that are in heaven today. That God looked down into heaven, into earth, and see people of whom he was trusted that child's with. And God gave you a wife to help you bring that child into being. And being that they're heritage of the Lord, that means that they really belong to God. And how you handle them, you're going to have to give an account for them one day. Amen. That's a scary thought, but it's the truth. Father, in Jesus' name, we pray for Christian, and we give you praise for this child. Lord, we have no idea what your plans is for this child, but we do know that, God, that you sent him here. And we know that every child has a purpose and an intent, and we pray for him in the name of Jesus. We're asking, God, that you'll put your hands upon him in the name of Jesus, that he might be the man for which, God, you've intended. And God, I'm asking that you would unfold the purpose in his life as he grows. Bless his parents that they may have wisdom far beyond years, that they may guide and nurture this child into the person of whom, God, you intended. We give you praise. And God, now in Jesus' name, as you have given this child unto them, they are now giving the child back to you, asking, God, that your hand might be upon him. For God, we pray this in the name of Jesus, that name is high above every name, that at that name every knee will bow and every tongue will confess that he is Lord to the glory of God. Pray this in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. All I got is a birth certificate. But here's the day that maybe one day when I'm an old or gray guy, and I ain't getting too far from that now, little guy, that one day, I don't know what you guys are going to wind up being. Look at my little darling, my little sweetheart. Maybe you might be the pastor one day. Maybe God may let me live long enough to see. I don't know what the plans are. But maybe they say that was a pastor that dedicated me a little old church in Oviedo called Antioch. So today the certificate of baby dedication says, we hereby commit to raising this child, talking about you, Alan and Mary, Christian Jordan Popolis, in the nurture and admonition of the Lord on the 19th day of November in the year of our Lord 2023 at Antioch Missionary Baptist Church. Pastor Charles Jones, pastor. Amen. Amen. We give this to you. Y'all may be seated. Thank you all for coming. Amen. Amen. Thank you.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Amen. Our scripture is going to be coming from 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verses 9 and 10. 1 Chronicles, chapter 4, verses 9 and 10. And it reads, and again, thank you, Minister Tarr. That's going to be 1 Chronicles, everybody. 1 Chronicles, chapter 4, verses 9 and 10. And Jabez was more honorable than his brethren, and his mother called his name Jabez, saying, because I bear him with sorrow. Verse 10. And Jabez called on the God of Israel, saying, oh, that thou wouldest bless me indeed and enlarge my coast, and that thine hand might be with me, and that thou wouldest keep me from evil, that it may not grieve me. And God granted him that which he requested. God bless you and keep you is my prayer.
Amen. Let's church sing amen. Let's give the Lord a hand for our music ministry. Come on, y'all. Amen. Coming to this every Sunday is a blessing. Amen. You may be seated. You may be seated. Before I get started, my baby and I were on vacation, and so we had to break it off and come back, and so we got some things to do. Then we'll finish it up after we get done what we're supposed to do. Amen. So in this afternoon, we have an engagement to be at my home church where it all started for me at Mount Zion. And so I'll be preaching there at 3:00. Then we'll start on vacation again. Amen. Let me have your Bibles turn to the book of 1 Chronicles chapter 9. Alan, Mary, thank you all so much for letting me play a small part in those children's journey. Amen. Here in the book of 1 Chronicles, Pastor Thomas read in your hearing. As I said before, you know, we came at from this passage from a different angle than you normally hear this passage being taught or preached. And so often when we come at it from different angles, God's word can never be exhausted. You never can get everything out of it. I guarantee you, if I ask either of these preachers to come and preach from this passage, they'll come up with something else right from this passage. But here, as God was talking about the sons of Judah, in the midst of this naming of these different sons and their fathers, God paused for two verses to speak about a man called Jabez, and it reads, and Jabez was more honorable than his brethren. That word honorable means heavy. He was more respectable than his brothers. Don't mean that they don't have any respect, but he had a little bit more. You ever seen a bunch of people in a family and one child seemed to stand out over the rest? Y'all seen a whole bunch of jacked up kids, jacked up family? Y'all seen some family, all of them bad. Then one of them you can deal with. I'm not saying this is the case here. It just says that Jabez was more honorable or respectable than his brother. And there's a colon in my Bible, which means that God had said enough at that point about this man. But that colon and that pause in that verse meant something. Every dot over that I, every cross over the T, every comma, everything in Scripture has a significant meaning. And when that colon was behind than his brethren, there was enough being said about him at that point. But it says, and his mother called his name Jabez, saying, because I bear him with sorrow. As you all know, the last couple of weeks, as we was talking about this sermon, we discussed some baby mama and baby daddy issues that can also cause baby issues. Come on, somebody. When there's baby mamas and baby daddy issues, it can also bleed over into having baby issues. And this is what we're going to see here in this text. And as mentioned in our previous sermons, when children get caught up in the crossfire, somebody say crossfire, of domestic issues between the parents, those children can get injured unintentionally. Priest, pastor, can y'all pray with me for a little bit? Y'all got a minute that we can talk? Y'all have a minute? Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you, God, for this word, asking they won't be hindered because of my inadequacy. I'll ask in Jesus' name that you'll make the word of God real in their hearts. Lord, I'm asking in Jesus' name, those things that I forget to say, I'm asking your spirit would speak to their hearts. And those things that I need not say, I ask, God, you will block that out. And we give you praise, God, for the blessedness, God, of getting a chance to hear the word of God. Because we know this word is filled with faith, and we can gain it from listening to the word. For faith come by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. And we trust you for this. Now, open up our eyes that we may behold wondrous things from thy law. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. When I said that sometimes when there's baby mama issues and baby daddy issues, then sometimes it bleeds over to having baby issues. Come on, pastor. Help us. And I said that in the sermon that sometimes the children get caught in the crossfire of those domestic issues between their parents, whether or not they're married or sometimes they're unmarried. And nevertheless, everybody in this room have a mama and a daddy. If you don't, we're going to ask that you leave now because we're afraid of you. But everybody in this room have a mama and have a daddy. And and sometimes these children in this domestic issues between the parents, the kids are sometimes unintentionally injured or scarred. Amen, somebody. And we said last week, and to add insults upon the injuries or the scars that they go through sometimes, some of these children are forced to have an allegiance to either their mama or their daddy. Y'all seen it, Amy, y'all seen it, where one of the parents would, we would say intentionally, like we spoke last week, by intention, would try to taint or to bring a toxic relationship between one or two of the parents. And the children are forced to make an allegiance to either their mama or their daddy. Come on, come on. Can y'all gonna help me? Don't y'all get mad with me. I just wanna, God told me to say this and I gotta say it. And I wanna say that some adults that's maybe sitting in this room today is still carrying some scars inflicted upon them when they were children. Amen. Scars wherein, can I talk about the scars, and maybe they're going to bring it up. Scars such as unexplained mental and emotional issues. Scars such as sickness in their bodies. Come on, I don't know if they're going to bring it up. Are they unable to adapt in social settings? Amen. And sometimes they never feel comfortable in a relationship. Because of these scars that some people are carrying today, and somebody wonder, why in the world do you feel that way? Why in the world do you deal in life that way? Why you get so emotionally over this so much? Why is it that you're so touchy over that issue? And sometimes they get find that the children are being sick in their body. When all I'm saying, why these kids are being sick? Sometimes when your emotions is messed up and your mental, come on, Mia, you nurse, y'all know that sometimes people go get some help, not because something starts out physically, but sometimes those things, you know, kind of go into stuff like stress and high blood pressure and all these different things. They come as a result of being under strain mentally and emotionally. And sometimes we can, and those things bleeds over into other diseases and other things that affects their body. And sometimes we got adults that has been inflicted with these things and not knowing where they came from, but little Johnny and little Mary had to deal with that when they was children. And they internalized some things that was going on between mama and daddy. The baby loved mama and they loved daddy too. And they're caught between loving my daddy and loving my mama. And how do I navigate between the two? Come on, y'all. I'm be done with this, you know. But we're going to talk about something today because we're going to talk about mama drama and daddy drama. We're going to talk about the baby going to succeed under all odds. Come on. I don't know if I'm going to have enough time to do this, but can I say that there are some people in this room right now has already told me, even from the very first sermon, that you could relate to what I've been talking about. That you're still angry with your mama, still angry with your daddy, still angry with someone, still wondering why you're having these issues in your life. And you don't know why, but when you were an 8-year-old boy, 8-year-old girl, or whatever it was, you watched these things and you internalized them and you just has never, and that's why when somebody married you or somebody in relation with you, they think they're dealing with an adult in you when they still deal with a little girl in you. The unhealed little girl or the unhealed little boy has never been healed. And every time you do something that remotely remind them of what they went through as a child, you wonder, girl, I know you're going, no, you're still fighting the little girl in her. You're still dealing with the little boy in him that was never healed. Come on, somebody. Then you go and marry that person not knowing that the little girl in them that has never been healed or the little boy has never been healed. And now you got to live with the little boy and the little girl. You have the I told y'all one time, and I'm gonna leave this one. I told y'all one time I was in high school, and I thought I was cool, amen. And a girl named Ella Jean slapped me side my head for looking at another girl. And I'm saying this: you gotta watch what you name your babies. Look like people got two names. You call them when you call them. You call somebody Ella Jean or Willie Joe or Bell Hearing. You don't know who gonna hit you, Ella or John or who. You know, when you call him Willie Lee or Willie John, somebody, you don't know, somebody, Willie may be okay, but John, maybe Willie John, might knock you out. So I have Israel people calling me, so call me, just give me one name to deal with. Just. Now, having these issues that Jabez has had to deal with, Jabez is a perfect, somebody say perfect. He's a perfect example of a person who has every reason to go through life feeling insecure and unimportant. Here's why. We can only imagine how hard it was because his mother named him Jabez. Jabez, which means son of my sorrow, or son of my pain. All of his life, he was scrapped with a name that reminded him of what his mother felt while she was giving birth to him. And we can only imagine what this boy must have been growing up in a home where he felt like he didn't quite feel welcome. Because every time that his mother looked at him, he reminded her of what she was going through. And we ask y'all about daddy drama. We wonder, where was daddy in the first place, where normally a man would be the one that would especially name his son. But in this case, Jabez's mother named him a name, my pain. Normally a daddy, we showed you last week where sometimes when a daddy would step up and say, no, you ain't name my baby. No, that, no, he ain't gonna walk with that name. But somehow Jabez's daddy never intervened. And we ask the question, where was daddy?
And last week, I don't know how many daddies I lost, but it's kind of empty today than it was last Sunday. Maybe some of the guys didn't want to come back to hear this one. But this boy didn't quite feel welcome in his home. How bad it is for a child to come home and not feel like they were unwanted. You be careful about telling a child you wasn't playing. And remind a child that you were only here because of this. And I shared with y'all a story of a young man that talked this way. And you would hate to hear a child feel like they were somebody's mistake, somebody's product of somebody's pleasure. In other words, we didn't want you. And even if we got pregnant, we're not happy on it because we feel sad that you just came to be a burden. So even at his birth, Jabez was looked upon as a product of someone's dilemma and blamed for someone's discomfort. He was looked at as this the name Jabez became his badge of identification. Hey, pain. Every time they called his name, hey, pain, hey, trouble. Jabez had to deal with that all of his life. Most of us, when we studied this passage, we love the passage where he prayed and asked God for all these blessings, but we don't talk about what came up to all of this. We got books on it. We got placards on our house. The prayer of Jabez. But you better be careful about wanting what somebody got. And you don't know somebody's story. All you're looking at is where they are right now. But you don't know how I got to be blessed as I am. You don't know. And you'll find people trying to undercut you and undermine you. But they don't know what you've done. They don't know what you've had to deal with to be so blessed. Come on, don't y'all push me now. Don't push me. But you don't know my story. You're going around trying to cut me off, trying to keep somebody from giving something to me. But you don't know my story. You don't know at night when I pray. You don't know what I ask God for. You don't know what God is doing. Come here, somebody. You don't know the tears that I save. You don't know the nights that I save. You don't know. And here you are trying to cut my blessings off. The devil is alive. You got to find out somebody's story before you try to judge the book. You jealous because they drive in this and want to find out how much they make it and where they stay at. Or what's wrong with you? Are you out of your mind? You got to find out why God is blessing somebody else. Until you can celebrate somebody else, you will never be celebrated. Preach, John. Preach, John. Preach, Pastor. Somebody say, preach, Pastor. And yet with all of this going on, Pastor Tom, Jabez overcame the odds. His mother called him a pain. Maybe his siblings called him stuff. But the boy determined in his mind, I don't care what y'all call me. I don't care what y'all say about me. I'm not going to be what y'all say I am. Come on, somebody. For we read, he says, let me tell you this now. This boy prayed a prayer. And it appears when Jabez finally understood what his name meant, he sought God to remove the stigma associated with his name. When he finally got the dictionary, and somebody finally told him what that name means, Jabez said, no, I'm old enough now. I'm old enough now to know what this name means, Jones. I'm done. I want to get rid of this. And even if I got the name, I want God to remove the stigma associated with the name. So Jabez got bold enough to ask God to do something in spite of his name. In spite of what they call me, I'm going to beat all the odds because, see, y'all already said I ain't got no business having this. You already said I shouldn't be blessed, but praise be unto God. If God said I can have it, you can't say I can't. If God called me blessed, you can't say I'm blessed. Whatever you try to do against me, you better be careful. God will let you do the same. Every ditch you dig, you better be careful. You're going to fall in it. For every trench that you get on, you better be careful. For every word you say against me, you better be careful what you say, because the Bible says he'll take all every word that rise up against your God or condemn him. You better be careful about talking about somebody trying to undermine somebody. Jabez Ken, Jabez said, no matter what they said about me, no matter what they thought about me, I'm going to beat the odds. Mm-hmm. This man, he says, for we read Jabez, and Jabez, even though his mother called his name Jabez, but Jabez said, you call my name Jabez, but I'm going to call on the God of Israel. See, that's what you call me, Jabez, so I'm going to call somebody else higher than me. So Jabez prayed a prayer, and Jabez called on the God of Israel. This man, Jabez, was bold enough to ask God for things that exceeded what others thought he was worth. Who in the world you think you are asking for something like that? But this man, his own mama, didn't put much value on him, which is evident by the name she gave him. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. She didn't put no value on this child. It's a shame when your own parents don't put any value on you. Just throw you out there and let you make it the best you can. I'll feed you, just go ahead and eat. That's all I'm going to do at this point. I got clothes. You're drinking my water. That's enough for you. Don't be asking for nothing else. Never go to school. Never find out how you're doing. No, never. Don't care anything about it. I just had you. This man decided something, y'all. Somebody say he decided something. He was not going to allow what others thought of him to stop him pursuing what seems unrealistic. Come on, somebody. He said, I don't care what y'all think about me. I'm not going to allow what you think about me make me not believe God for something unrealistic. That's what I told you in Antioch. I got some haters in this church. They mad at me right now because God keep blessing and they can't understand it. They think I got something going on. No. But you got to know, praise God, I'm believing God for things that some of you ain't got enough faith to believe God for. Amen. So that's why God called me to be the pastor, not you. Because God know I'm crazy enough to believe him for things that seems impossible. You better walk with me, somebody. God is looking for somebody who's crazy enough, even though you don't qualify, to ask for things that you... God will do it. He just needs you to have enough faith to get past your own qualification, get past your pedigree, get past all of that stuff, and to ask me for something that people say you got no business having. Oh, I wish I had two people in church. I wish I had two people to believe God for something that they said you're not qualified for. Some of y'all sitting right now, y'all need to put a praise on what you believe in God for. Come on, somebody. Because if God be for you, can't nobody be against you. God, if God got something for you, I don't care what they say. I don't care what they do behind the doors. I don't care what they're doing on the table. God will cut them off. God has ordained some things in this room for somebody today, but you're not having enough faith because you keep looking at yourself and worrying about what people are going to say about you. You got to get that out of your mind. I don't care what you say about me. Yes, I done this. Yes, I did that. Yes, I came from over here. Yes, I went there. Yes, I said this, but God. Everybody need to have a but God moment. I don't care what you say about me, but God, everybody need a but God moment. I just wish you had gone on vacation. Jabez, up until this point, had not, baby, he didn't have the confidence to ask him half a whole lot. He didn't have us come to ask God for a whole lot because he didn't feel like I deserve it. And many of you don't ask for God because you think you deserve things. God is not looking for something because none of us deserve anything from God. And you're still waiting around to ask God for something, hoping that you can somehow deserve. I'm going to go to Sunday school more. I'm going to do this more. Stop it. God never called you by works, but by his grace. Grace is unmerited. Nothing you did for God just blessed you. I said I wasn't going to shout. Because I got to preach again. But if we pay very close attention, when this man says, listen, I ain't had confidence before, baby, to ask God for nothing big. I ain't had no confidence over, you know, but for some reason, Jabez bumped into God, Jones. See, what God will do when you are afraid to ask God for some big things, but an encounter with God, you find out how big God is. You say, say what? God said, I can do exceedingly. God said, go ahead and ask me for something. Come on, somebody. Go ahead and put out your best wish. Go ahead, give me your best prayer. Go ahead, give me your best request. God says, I can do exceedingly and abundantly above all that you could ever ask or think. You say, so God said, if you can think about it, I can. Oh. Come on here, somebody. God said, give me your best prayer. Give me your biggest request. I'm big enough. Come on, somebody. I'm powerful enough. I'm God. I can do anything. I can speak it and it comes. I can do exceedingly and abundantly above all you could ever ask or you could even think about. God said, if you think about it, I can bless you with it. If y'all want to go to these preachers, don't believe God for something, you don't need to be in Antioch. Not in this church. Amen, somebody. I want every one of our members to believe God for big things. Believe for big things. People told you you ain't bright enough to have this. You're not educated enough to have this. Believe God for it. And y'all with them baby mamas and baby daddy dramas, forget that stuff. If he left you, honey, tell him to hit the door. Kick the door on him when he leaves. Come on, somebody. If he feel like, come on, somebody, if he feel like you're not good enough for him, good riddance, brother. I got me a man, the man Christ Jesus. Come on, somebody, who can give me everything I've ever wanted, who can be with me in the midnight hour. I got me a man. Come on, somebody. But we don't never see the man in church. You come to church every Sunday by yourself, you think I am. He's just so big. He's just so wide. You can't even see him. I got some good notes too, y'all. I got good notes. And don't look like I'm going to get all these notes. But if we pay very close attention, we'll discover this man, Jabez, has inherited a terrible complex about himself. And if you don't watch yourself, that's why watch your children. Pay close attention to your kids. Watch what hurts them. Watch what they move by. Watch what makes them sad. Watch your children. Because sometimes you don't know you can be scarring them. Come on, somebody. I'm not saying sometimes we need it. I mean, y'all know what I'm talking about. You know. I ain't saying that. Don't go out here and think as a Pastor Jones said. No, you don't beat little Johnny. The Bible says a child left himself and bring a mother shame. It said, beat him, and if he cried, ain't gonna kill him because it'll keep his soul out of hell. So I ain't talking about that. There comes a time when little Johnny, little JoJo get out of place, it's time to put the thing on him. Humble somebody. How many in this room know that if some whoopings that you got that made you the man and the woman you are today? So I ain't talking about that. I ain't talking about that. But we will discover in this text that this boy inherited a terrible complex about himself. I told you I talked to a girl. She was absolutely stunningly beautiful. But all of her life she grew up having her siblings call her ugly. And they were calling her ugly because they were jealous of her. Come on, somebody. If somebody says something to you long enough, you'll stop believing their story. Come on, somebody. They kept telling her because all of her siblings was very jealous of this very good-looking girl. But they kept saying, you're so ugly. You got this. And before long, she had bought what they were selling her. And now here she was sitting in front of me, beautiful girl, thinking that all of her life she'd been ugly. And feeling like if a guy do come next to me, he's just doing it out of pity. Not knowing the guy going, whoa, mom, got me somebody. Woo! She having a different, totally different thought about herself. What do you think about yourself? Come on, Jabez's. Bay Jezreez for the girls. What do you think about yourself? How do you feel about yourself? What is it? What stigma has been placed on your life that you need to shed? Who told you that you're not good enough? Who told you that you got to just stuck with what you got? Come on, somebody. You got to have enough faith. God is looking for a man or a woman that got enough faith to believe him for things that seems impossible. And every time you start believing God for something like that, you'll always get haters going to come out. Come on, somebody. It appeared. This boy said, God, you know what? I need to get the... This guy said, I want to ask something, God, because I want to ask you something, God, that people say I'm not worth. Because even his mama didn't put a whole lot of value on him. He says, but God, I'm going to call upon you. Jabez decided he was not going to allow anybody to keep him from pursuing what he felt God can do for him. Until you get a new perspective on God, about who God is. God don't care about because you look good or you've done this. No, no, no. God loves you just the way you are. You know why? Because he made you just the way you are. So God is not surprised about what you look like. God is not surprised about your status in life. God knew all that whole while. He just wants you, in spite of that situation, to believe him to bring you out of it if it's going to bring him glory. Well, you know, we raised up a single mom, six of us. Come on, somebody. God has saved all of us with a single mom. Amen, somebody. Single mom. Hallelujah. And she only went to sixth grade. Hallelujah, somebody. Wasn't no help for me to homework. Wasn't no help for me. But somehow God blessed all of her kids. All of us. Because you know what my mama did? My mama started praying and asking God to give me what she couldn't give. Come on, somebody. Y'all got to, come on, somebody. Sometimes you have to ask God to do what you can't do yourself. See, God wanted where you can't take credit for some things. That's why I think God, I'm so glad God can bless you, because when people think they gave you something, they always say, I gave you this. I done this for you. The devil is a lie. The Bible says every good, every perfect gift come from God. There was a woman who was always praising God. She was praising God. Every time she got something, she kept praising God. Every time, so the atheist was standing next door to her. Every time she got to, oh, praise God, just bless me. So one day the lady got hungry. They have no food to eat. And she was sitting on the porch wondering how she was going to make it. The atheist kept looking at her and said, uh-huh, you talking about God is so good. Praise God. He good all the time. And look at you. You ain't got no food to eat. And the girl said, God, I know you're going to bless it. Look, he said, look at you just praying. Look at you praying. Your God ain't going to do this. She kept praying. God, bless me. God, I ain't got no food for these kids. God, bless me. So the atheist said, I'm going to do something. The atheist went out to Publix, bought some groceries, milk, eggs, everything. Bought everything that she needed and brought it to the house. And the woman put it on the porch, and he sit behind the bushes. And the woman came out and got the blessing. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise you, God, for the groceries. Praise God. And the atheist jumped out from behind the bush, say, see there? That wasn't God, that me. This is it. And you make the devil pay for it. Come on, somebody. Oh, praise God. Yes, sir. See, God will cause your enemies to be your footstool. You got to understand something. God know how to bless you, honey. He'll make your enemies, the ones that are trying to hurt you, God will make them same one bless you. Come on, somebody. I ain't coming to pass appreciation money until the month is over, because I don't want to give him none of my money. Praise God. God will say, I'll make it where, praise God, you will have nobody else but the pastor to bless. Oh, God. His prayer. Y'all, somebody say his prayer. When he prayed, he said his prayer seemed to indicate that he was causing problem for everybody else. Y'all seen the prayer? Because here's what the man says. Notice, his prayer was not only laden with faith, y'all. His prayer was also laden with fear as well. Because here's what he prayed. He says this in 1 Chronicles chapter 4, verse 10. He says, let your hand be with me and keep me from harm so that I will be free from pain. It seems at some point, Tara, he may have been physically hurt or threatened by to be hurt. Therefore, he prays for God's protection and provision. He said, God, I don't want to cause no pain. Come on, sir. God, I want your hands to be with me, because I don't want to cause no pain, and I don't want nobody to cause me pain. So the boy was praying with both faith and fear at the same time. Come on, somebody. Because sometimes your faith will drive you to fear. Come on, somebody. And sometimes your fear will drive you to faith. So now God got both of them in this text. Notice he prays how he prayed. And this boy went all in. He went all in, y'all. Somebody say he went all in. And Jabez called on the God of Israel, saying, "Oh, that thou wouldest bless me." Here it is, indeed. Not just bless me. And the word indeed means to be filled with strength. God, bless, don't just bless me, but bless me indeed. Then he said, enlarge, here it is, to become numerous, increase, become great and powerful. He says, my coast, that means my borders. God, he said, I'm not being ungrateful. I thank you for what you gave me. I appreciate that. I'm not being ungrateful. I'm not being unthankful. But God, I just need you to just move my boundaries out a little bit. Come on, somebody. God, this is what you gave me. But God, you know what? You big enough. You're the creator of everything. Could you just take my borders? Just say, God, just push my borders out. Don't take nothing from nobody else. So when you're pushing my borders, you're pushing theirs back. Come on, somebody. You're just enlarging my... Come on, somebody. God knows just how to bless you without cursing somebody else. Give me. God, just enlarge my territory. He said, God, this is mine. This, God, I take ownership of what you give me. I just need you to take what you've given me and just expand on it. Y'all have no idea. You have no idea. You're sitting in this preacher. You're sitting in the church. You have no idea what I pray. I pray every night of my prayer. God, make Antioch a token of your good to this community. Amen. Come on, somebody. You keep praying as a token. That means that every time that people think about Antioch, praise God, God is touching the whole community with Antioch. And God, you see how God, since we've been here, we was on maybe a quarter of an acre of land. God has moved over. We got 3 acres over here. Now God gave us another 3 acres down here. We got about 9 acres over here. We only had a little bit we got here. Praise God. But look what God keeps doing. And he keeps spreading the borders because you got to know that you know God can... You got to know that you know that God will do it. Yes, sir. And stop worrying about them haters. Yes, sir. I can't finish this up, Ken. I got to be done because I got to preach at 3 o'clock. But y'all, it's 11 o'clock. It's 11:30. Where y'all got to go at? Could y'all give me a couple more minutes? Jones, Jabez discovered the key to God's heart. Here's the key to God's heart. Proverbs chapter 22 and verse 4. Here it is. Y'all got it? Proverbs 22, verse 4. Look at it. He says, by humility and the fear of the Lord are riches, honor, and life. This is what every person in the world, everybody's born, want. Riches, honor, and life. And riches is things that you just need something to take care of yourself. Honor, that means you want some kind of respect. And life, all of us want to live in such a way that we don't have to go around groping a lot. God, but how are you going to get it? By humility and fear of the Lord. See, you got to humble yourself. You got to figure out that you ain't who you think. Girl, you're not a bag of chips and a soda. Bro, you know, the sun don't rise and shine on you, bro. See, if you don't humble yourself, God says he'll humble you. Can I say this, y'all? Don't get mad with me. I'm going to say this, and I know y'all don't want me to say it, but I'm going to say it. Y'all remember Colorado State with Deion Sanders? We here, boasting. We going to do this and do that. We going to do this, do this. We here. Notice in the last few weeks, God says, I'll humble. Come on, somebody. If you exalt yourself, he says, I'll humble you. Have y'all seen Deion's demeanor now? Now, he's about ready now to really get what he wants. By now, God, see, if you don't humble yourself, God will humble you. Because the Bible said God hate pride. And an arrogant look and a proud look, he can't stand. Come on, somebody. So when you walking around talking about what you're going to do, and we here and boasting right now, notice now, one game, whole bunch of points, and the team come back and beat him. Now he's getting beat by everybody. You know why? Because you better watch your pride. You better watch how you stick your chest out. Because that goes on for Christian, that goes for anybody. But humble yourself. Humble yourself. Just start thanking God for what you got. Thank God for doing these things. And God, see, if you walk around and be a humble person, somebody always be ready to bless somebody like that. None of us deserve anything. And don't start talking about what you're going to do to somebody or what nobody's going to do to you. Humble yourself. That's what Jabez did. That's why he was more honorable than all of his brothers. See, the Bible says that he was honored more heavy than all of his brothers. That brother, he humbled himself. He went to God. He said, God, oh, that thou wouldest bless me indeed. Enlarge my territory. The boy humbled himself. He did. Jabez realized if you want to go somewhere in life, it had to come from somebody who knew the way. Come on, somebody. He knew that if I'm going to go somewhere in life, I got to go to somebody who knows the way. And two, notice the word indeed. This man just didn't want people to say he was blessed, but he wanted himself to be a blessing. Yes. Come on, God, just give me just, no, God, just bless me. No, God want you to say, God, when you bless Charles, amen, everybody that come in contact with me going to be blessed when they leave me. When people leave you, what is it? Some of you so darn stingy. You're so stingy. You're so stingy. Your ears all twisted up. You're so stingy. Always looking out for yourself. Never investing in other people. Come on, somebody. You don't even, some of your money you got, you ought to invest in the youth ministry. So if you what I'm going to do, I'm going to fund the whole youth ministry. Yeah. If you ain't got no kids, invest in somebody else's kids. Come on, somebody. Mm-hmm, I ain't getting nobody my money. I'm going to get my money. I got my money in 501c. I got my money. Guess what? You might die in all of your little bonds and all your little stocks. Somebody going to spend in 3 days after you dead. Come on, somebody. God will take all that money you're trying to save and not invest in. God said, okay, it wasn't yours in the first place. I'm going to take it and give it to the Hoopin' Owl program. You better watch yourself. Yes. I'm going to close this up. I got some more notes. I said, come on, give me some more music. Any Jabez is in the house? Anybody ever was saying, I ain't going to let this stigma on me. From this day on, Pastor Jones, starting today, if you got something against your mama, against your daddy, against your co-workers, I want you to don't give them no more power. Say, you know what? I'm done with that. I'm over that. And sometimes your feeling ain't going to even catch. Sometimes you have to let your faith and let your feelings catch up with your faith. So you go do it. The Bible says, to whom I forgave anything, I forgave it in Christ. That Satan have no advantage over me. The reason why some of you are still, come on somebody, being in bondage, because you haven't released something or somebody. Jabez had every reason to hate his mama, hate his daddy. But you know, I ain't got time to do it to you. This man eventually had a school of prophets named after him, the school of Jabez. A whole city was named after him. The boy who they thought wasn't going to be nobody. If I had time to show you, this man became a school of the prophets. They become to come to his school and he was teaching them how to get in touch with God. So when you pray, God, he didn't just ask God to enlarge his border for himself. He says, God, enlarge my border so I can bring other people and find out they can overcome what has overcome them. Come on, somebody. Come on, let's give God a praise. Let's give God a praise. Come on, y'all, give God a praise. Everybody standing on your feet. I said I wasn't going to sweat. I just got a new fresh cut. I told my wife, she don't think my hair is curly. And I gotta do something. Could y'all give me two minutes, please? I just got a note. And we're not going to just, y'all sit down for one second. The parents of the other child is here. Come on, are they here? They're here. And we're not going to let them go home. Pastor, can I have my dedication? Just, y'all, just be seated for 1 minute. Y'all, you're coming right here. Amen. It's all about this baby. Where's my little baby? Bring the pastor. Bring certificate up. Amen.
You see what Pastor did? He all sweaty. He's still going to do it for you, bro. Amen. Hallelujah. Somebody say hallelujah. Amen. I got to make sure I get the name right. I know I had a piece of paper. Here it is. Here it is. I got it. Alton and Ashley. Amen. I want to say to y'all, as I said to the couple before, I thank God that I get a chance to dedicate these babies, because, man, ain't nobody dedicated me. They just had me. And I want to say, you, as I said to Alan and Mayor a few minutes ago, Alton and Ashley, this baby that y'all have is not by luck and by chance. God gave y'all this child. He thought enough of you guys to entrust you guys with this baby. Alton, there's men that wish they could stand in your shoes to say that this is my boy, this is my child. They can't do that. No matter what you've done in life, no matter what it was, God still entrusted you with this child. He's yours. And I said to Alan a few minutes ago, Alan, big dude, he's tall. You know, Aiden, he gonna think you the biggest dude in his whole, all his church. Aiden gonna think his dad the biggest dad in the whole world. So you have to set an example in front of Aiden like no other man in this church. I'm gonna read this, and here's a scripture I read a few minutes ago that you guys wouldn't hear, but I always read this passage from Mark chapter 10. And the Bible says, and it brought young children to him that he should touch them, and his disciples rebuked those that brought him. Disciples felt like, hey, my Lord is too busy for be messing with people's children. And the first time that Jesus got angry with his disciples, he got angry with them because they were trying to keep the little children from getting next to him. And the audacity of the parents to come up and asking him to touch them. Yeah, that's right. And the Bible says that, but when Jesus saw it, he was much displeased and said unto them, talking to his disciples, suffer little children to come to me and forbid them not, for such is the kingdom of heaven. Verily I say unto you, whosoever shall not receive the kingdom of God as a little child shall not enter therein. And those, God says, I want you to take an example of a child. This child's not worried about what he's going to eat in the morning. He's not going to worry about where he's going to sleep in the morning. He's not going to worry about whether or not you went to work and your boss got on your nerve. He ain't worried about that stuff. All he's worried about is when I get up in the morning, everything I need is going to be provided. That's children. That's how children. You know, sometimes we can get in an argument with somebody and be mad for the rest of our life. Somebody says something bad and we mad the whole while. But a child can be fighting little Johnny today, and tomorrow they playing in the playground. He said, that's how we got to receive the kingdom of God. That same way. He says, so children are an example for us to live by, and entrust you guys with that. So it is your duty, therefore, receive this child from God's hand and to teach him how to know and to love God from your obedience, from your example, not Pastor Jones, not from Pastor Beatty. It's from your example. You must bring these children where God's word is being taught. It is your duty to do this. And from your example, this child must learn how to pray, especially you, Daddy. Your children don't know that I got a praying dad. No matter what's going on in hell or high water, I got a praying dad. And Mom, it don't matter what nobody else say. Some of the biggest dudes in this room today, the biggest dudes in this room. No matter what nobody, see what he's saying? I'm telling you, no matter what nobody else say, Mama always have the last word. If you don't believe that Mama got power, let Mama get mad in the house. All the children get mad. The dog get mad. Even the fish won't even swim in the fish bowl no more. Because your words, Mama, you are very important. From your example, this child must learn how to read and love the Bible. From your example, the child must learn the way of fellowship with God. So I ask, as I ask Mary and Ellen, I ask you, Alton and Ashley, do y'all promise to pray for this child that he may grow into knowledge of God and spiritual life? Y'all promise to do that?
to your promise to train this child in body, mind, and soul for the service and fellowship with God. Y'all promise to do that. I want you to take this baby. I want you to do this, Alton. Take your baby and let everybody know your child's name. Amen. Is the godparents here? Is Tony and Anisha here? Y'all watching online? Tony and Anisha, we're just going to do this by faith. I got to find a camera I can look into, one of them. Do you promise to do everything in your power to help Alton and Ashley raise this child in the way that God wants this child to be raised? If you're there, just raise your hand. We just believe by faith. Now, in the event that anything happened to Ashley and Alton, you're saying that you're willing to raise this child in the nurture and admonition of the Lord. That's what you're saying. I'm looking at this camera here. Amen. We just believe by faith that you're doing just that. Any grandparents here? Grandma, granddaddy, grandma, y'all come up, come up. Got one grandmother coming. And his brother, come on, brother, come on, come on, come to me. Grandma, I said earlier at the dedication of my other baby, I said that I got 9 grandkids and I love every one of them. And I said that I'm going to say it to you too. When it comes to grandparents, if I could get my grandkids before I got my children, I would have. I get to sugar them up, let them run around all, stay up late, then ask Candace and Donnie to come get them. Amen. And they would get so angry with me, especially my daughter, says, Dad, I don't believe the things that you let these kids get away with, you wouldn't stand it for 1 second. But that's the privilege of having a grandparent, being a grandparent. So I'm saying to you, Grandma, in the event, God forbid, if anything happened to Alton or Ashley, are you willing to raise this baby, do it all over again, as if it was your very own? Are you going to do this? Are you going to do this? Okay, we're going to anoint it. This your little brother, and you got to walk. You got to walk. You got to set an example for your little brother. Amen. You got to walk. Be a good example for him to follow. Amen. Let's pray. Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you, Lord, for this child. We give you praise and we give you glory for him. Lord, in Jesus' name, we ask that you would cause this child to be what you've intended. And God, in this church, we dedicate him to you because it was you who had him, and now you entrusted him to these parents. God, in Jesus' name, we pray your blessings upon this child, that it might be what you have already purposed. And for this, God, we say thank you, that we get to play a small part in this child's journey and to the purpose for which you have already destined. For we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Here's this baby dedication from you guys. We hereby commit to raising this child, Aiden Ashford, in the nurture and the admonition of the Lord on the 19th day of November 2023 at Antioch Baptist Church. And we'd like to give you this certificate. And we say thank you. And let me almost sign this too right here. Now, when that child get to be a man of God, it might become Pastor Manuel, never know. He can remember this day, a little gray-haired pastor. I think his name was Charles Jones. Signed my dedication. To you, we say to you, thank you so much for letting us be a small part. God bless you. God bless you. Give me this to you.
Pray for us. We're going to Mount Zion this evening at 3 o'clock. For those that would like to come, come over to my home church and meet my mom and him. God bless you.
Amen. Well, praise God. Give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Amen. If there's anybody that would like to give their life to Christ as we stand, if there's anybody after this awesome message on how God changed Jabez's life, amen. God is a game changer for our life. And if we turn from our way and turn to God, God can do some great things in our life. So if there's anybody that today, after hearing this message, you want to put your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, you can come. Our counselors are waiting today. Is there somebody today that wants to come and give your life to Christ? You can come. And we'll say a prayer with you to God. And you can receive Christ as your Savior today if you want to come. Also, we thank God for these who have come. Also, if there's anybody that want to come and join the church, you can come as well. Is there anybody that's been visiting for a while and you want to come and you want to join today, you can come as well. Basically, it's an outward show of something that God does within our hearts. And so we want to go ahead and just say the prayer of salvation with you guys. And basically, when we recite this prayer, we're talking to God who sees everything. And God is the one who sent Jesus to die for our sins and to be raised again for our justification. And it's us today admitting that we're sinners, but putting our faith in Jesus, amen, and receiving him as our Savior and Lord. And once we do that, the next step is baptism, to show the world that what we've done in our hearts, we're going to do outwardly and publicly, is in obedience to God, amen. And so we're going to say this prayer. As we say this prayer, we're praying to the Lord. So let's look to the Lord. God,
I admit
that I'm a sinner. And that I do things wrong. But I thank you. For sending Jesus. To live a holy life. And to die for my sins. And to be raised again. From the dead. For my justification. Jesus.
I accept you
as my Savior. And my Lord. Come into my life. Lead me. Guide me. Give me your spirit. That you promised. To all those. That believe. I'm a child of God. I'm saved. In Jesus' name. Amen. So, welcome to the family of God. I always like to say that you have a new birthday today. So you have a birthday that you were born to your mom and dad, but you also have a birthday that you were born of God today. So go with our counselors. They'll share more of you on how you can be baptized. God bless you and God keep you is our prayer. Right, and if there's anybody who is in need of prayer in any circumstance or any situation, we want you to stand where you are, and we want to pray with you right where you are. Amen. And also just knowing that God is a God, as Pastor was preaching, that can do far more than we can ever imagine. And just as Jabez had some situations in his life that God changed, there's situations in our life that if we continue to believe in God, God is going to minister in our lives the way, and God's word is not going to return to him void, but it's going to prosper in your life to do what God sent it to do. Amen. So God, we thank you and we give you praise on today. We thank you, God, for your word that never returns to you void, but that goes forth to prosper in what you sent it to do. And we're here today, God, many of us that have had challenges in our life, God, and have challenges in our life is Jabez, but Jabez called upon you, and you heard his prayer. And today, God, we're calling upon you in our different situations in our lives, God. Today, we're calling on you, praying, God, that you would minister to us, Lord God, that you would help us, that your hand would be upon us, that you would be with us, Lord God, that you would stretch out our borders, God, and God, that you would bless us, that we may also be a blessing to others. We thank you, God, that just as 1 Chronicles 4 and 9 says that you heard the prayer of Jabez and you gave him what he requested, we thank you, God, that there is a room full of people today. Their name may not be Jabez, but you know their name. And God, we're praying, God, for you to do the same for us, God. And we thank you, God, that according to your word in 1 Chronicles 4 and 9, that you also hear our prayer. Is you are not a respecter of persons. God, we thank you for ministering and we thank you for the testimonies that will come forth even from this prayer. We thank you and we give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen. And now may God be with you. May God keep you. May the goodness and mercy follow you all the days of your life. Is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. God be with you and keep you all. Have a great rest of your week.